was looked on as something shocking. Now heaven knows anything
showing up yet.
Fine pal, I'm sailing tonight. He doesn't even show.
Oh, he'll be here. Keep your shirt on.
You fool. So you finally got here.
I'm sorry to be late, but I have big business. Hello, all.
Hello, Billy.
Gee, Billy, I wish you were sailing with us.
So do I.
Well, why don't you? Vacation will do you good. We can have a lot of fun together in London.
I know, but what's the use of talking? The boss is going away and he's leaving me in full charge. Now, if I make good, he's going to promote me from general manager to junior partner.
And what does that mean?
What does it mean? Well, what does it mean? Well, maybe $10 more a week or something.
Success!
And that's not all. Next year, I'm going away, and I'm going to leave the boss in charge. Now, if the kid makes good, I'm going to make him junior partner, and that makes me the senior partner. Get it?
Yeah, I get it. I get everything, except what I want. Is much too sad to be told, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is the cat. From champagne, here alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some like that perfume from that if I took even one sniff, that would bore me terrifically too. Yet I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time.
your pardon, but I couldn't help but noticing you seem to be in some trouble or something. Could I help you? Oh, thanks.
You're Miss Hope Harcourt, ain't you?
Yes.
I got a message for you. Will you come outside?
Don't go, mister.
Got a watch? Sit where you are and don't move for 5 minutes. I'll be a good little boy.
Go away.
What are you doing over here?
Nothing. I'll be with you in a minute. About 2 minutes and 36 seconds.
See, what is this, a gag or something?
No. I've been looking all over the boat for you.
Hello, Billy. I hardly expected
you. Why, you didn't think I was going to let you leave without saying goodbye, did you? It'll only be a minute. Where'll you be?
Well, if I'm not in the chapel, I'll be in the bar.
Wrong.
Come on, kid.
Right here, please, Bishop. Thank you very much indeed. Snap your shutter, Rembrandt.
Who you got there?
A missionary and a couple of celestials.
Take the missionary for a walk, and I'll get you a real picture.
Okay, kid. Oh, Bishop, would you give me a little dope about yourself?
Why, my photograph, I thought...
But we want to get a picture of you walking up the stairs.
Oh, I see.
What is the purpose of this trip, Bishop?
Oh, I'm on my way to attend the Westminster Conference. Confidentially, if you wish to cable your English correspondent, the entire conference will be at the Southampton docks to welcome me. And our Chinese body will be there also to do honor to my boys.
That's all very interesting. Make a swell story for our Chinese edition.
What are those guys doing down here?
Who are they?
They're G-men.
G-men?
Yeah, they're here for a pinch.
Hello, Mr. Whiskers.
Wise guy.
Yeah.
Oh, you're not down here for the ride. Give me the story.
Maybe there won't be any story. We're looking for a couple of mugs, that's all. They're trying to make a getaway.
Well, who are they? Maybe I can help you out.
One of them's dressed up like a preacher.
All ashore that's going ashore. All ashore that's going ashore.
I beg your pardon.
You ought to look where you're going.
Hey, fix the violin. Fix the violin.
Bonnie, it scares me to death. I'll never get used to this thing.
Well, anyway, you got on all right.
Yeah, but I'm going to get into trouble in this get-up. I don't know how to act like a minister. I don't see why I couldn't have been a cowboy or an Indian squawk or something.
Now, you look great in that preacher suit, Mooley. I'd hardly know you myself. Now, just keep your head and we'll make a clean getaway. I'll go find Snake Eyes.
Hey, Bonnie.
Charlie. Wang. Oh, Charlie. Oh, Wang. Oh, Doctor, I beg your pardon. May I present myself? The name is Bishop Henry T. Dobson.
Yeah, hello, Bish.
Are you on your way to the conference?
No. I think I'll go to bed early tonight.
No, I mean the Westminster Conference.
Well, you see, I'm not exactly a Westminster. I'm more in the East.
Oh, I see. Well, Dr. May I ask, what is your field?
Well, I'm a kind of a sort of a missionary.
missionary?
Yeah.
Where?
Yeah, oh, way out in China.
China?
Yeah, yeah, way, way out in China.
What?
Yeah, look at...
Singular thing. I've served in China for years.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you see, I wasn't exactly in China. I was more in the...
Oh, I see. You were in Indochina.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I was in Indo China and you was in outdoor China.
I see. Well, we shall see lots of each other, I hope, and I'll see you later.
Yeah, well, make it as late as possible, won't you?
Oh, Taiyonglei, long, long, long.
Well, I don't know. Maybe the captain will tell you about that.
119 and three quarters. Sell. I got you, Mr. Whitney.
That's fine, William. I think that's everything. Remember, William, I'm depending on you.
And I won't let you down, sir. Pleasant voyage.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Ooh, come here.
What's the matter?
There's a couple of dicks on board, and they're looking for you and Snake Eyes.
How do you know?
I've been trailing them.
You better take the harmonica. Where can I hide?
Stay away from your cabin. They're watching that. Get into a group.
Yeah, but get into a what?
Get into a group of passengers. I'll find you later.
Hey, Billy!
Oh, here we are. Now you're waiting in the chapel. Well, I just got time for one short polis, then I gotta go. You know, the boat's gonna sail in a minute.
Oh, Billy, come on along.
Oh, sure. Stay with the group.
You know I can't, Reno.
But, Billy, I can't have any fun in London without you.
What do you mean you'll be a riot in London? You'll have those monocles dropping in your lap like flies.
Why, is that so?
Well, I want you there, too.
Yeah, I'll be there.
Say, Doctor, would you mind converting somebody else? I'm beyond help, I think. Well, that's me. Come on, get off.
There he is. Let's go.
All ashore.
Now, Billy, this is your last chance. Are you sailing with me or aren't you?
You know I'd love to, but I gotta work.
Listen, why can't we be groupies?
Holy tomatoes.
Oh, that man thing again.
Hey, widows. Hey. Listen, will you sort of kick this fellow around till he gets lost?
Wang! Charlie! Wang! I beg your pardon. Have you seen anything of two Chinese gentlemen?
No, sir. No, sir. The clergy's closing in on me, honey.
Good evening, Bishop.
Oh, how do you do?
You are the bishop.
Oh, yes. The name is Henry T. Dobson. D.D. L.L.D. B.A.
Okay.
This way.
I know, but gentlemen.
Only be a second, Bishop.
Ah!
All ashore that's going ashore. All ashore that's going ashore.
Listen, I tell you what you do. You grab yourself a place up there on the upper deck, and I'll be waving to you. Make that last you till you get back. Bye, kids.
Bye!
Sir, you're coming aboard or going ashore. Hey, away!
A sailor's life is supposed to be a heck of a lot of fun.
Yeah, but when you're a sailor, take it from me, you work like a son of a gun.
They give us jobs of every kind and chores of every sort.
But sweat away, sailor, you don't mind, 'cause you know when we hit port,
there will always be a lady fair, a Jenny fair or a Sadie fair. There'll always be a lady fair who's waiting there for you. There will always be a lady fair to smooth your troubles and to muss your hair. There'll always be a lady fair who's waiting there for you. Thank you. woman's charms.
To kill your worries and to fill your arms,
there'll always be a lady fair who's waiting there for you.
Hello? Billy, so you're sailing with me after all. Oh, I'm so happy. What happened?
Well, you see, there's a girl on this boat.
A girl?
The most beautiful face I've ever seen.
So?
Well, she's in danger.
Well, who is she? What kind of danger?
I don't know.
You don't know who she is?
No.
Or what kind of danger she's in?
When
I asked you to sail with me, you couldn't. You had big business.
Well, I had.
Yeah, so you stayed aboard on her account. So your heart was full of deceit and it was just a runaround you were giving me.
Well, Reno, I never made a play for you.
Never had a man make a stronger play. You made me think you wanted to marry me.
Oh, now, how could you think that? I only treated you with respect.
Well, that's just it. If you weren't on the level, then why did you treat me with respect? Did you ever try to get me drunk? No. Did you ever ask me up to your apartment to look at your etchings? No. We've been in taxis dozens of times. Did you ever try to kiss me? No, not a try. Billy, you shouldn't have led me on like that if you didn't mean it.
Well, Reno, I didn't mean to mislead you.
Yes, you didn't. You never even laid a hand on me, and I'm not used to men treating me like that.
Well, we're on our way.
That's a nice piece of guessing, Doc.
Yeah, I want to thank you for what you did for me. It was a great favor.
Well, I don't know what it was, but whatever it was, you're welcome to it.
You mind if I park the frame?
No, put it...
Sit down.
Go ahead.
You see, when you surrounded me with all those girls, you hid me from some people I didn't want to see.
Yes, I know. I can't say goodbyes either. That's why I'm on this boat. Couldn't say goodbye to a girl. Now I'm in a devil of a fix. Pardon me, Reverend.
You're the devil with that. Anyway, you did me a favor. Maybe I can do you one. You look awful sad. You must have something on your mind.
Well, it's nothing you can help. It's money, and I know you ministers haven't got much of that.
Oh, if it's money you want, I can get some of that.
Can you?
Why, sure. The fellow that's sailing with me has got about $50,000 with him. Yeah, I'll just go get him.
Mooney!
Yeah, Barney, where's Mr. Hill?
I was just going to tell you, he didn't make the boat.
Why? Did the cops get him? Was he forcibly detained?
I don't know about that. He just never showed.
Wait a minute. Do you suppose we could get the money back on his ticket?
Is that a ticket? Oh, that's just as good as money.
Oh, well, if it's a ticket you want, you can have that one. Of course, we may have to share the same bedroom, but I guess there's two bunks in it.
Why, that's all right. Thanks awfully, Reverend.
Yeah, what is it? What you want?
Fix me up.
Oh, excuse me, mister. this is the little lady that goes with Mr. Hill.
You don't mean that she goes with the ticket?
Yeah, well, I thought perhaps maybe she...
No, Reverend. You'll have to assume responsibility for her. Thank you.
Oh, I was afraid of this. Mr.
Crocker, Billy Crocker.
It's a pleasure to know you.
I'd see you.
Do you suppose you could use his passport?
No, I don't think I'll have to land. Still, I might come in handy. Heaven help me if they ever look at this picture.
Oh, well, we could fix that up all right.
Pardon me, Reverend. May I take a picture of you and your party?
No, not me. No, not with me, but I'd like a picture of my friend here.
Oh, no, hey, I don't...
Be sure you get a good close picture.
I see.
Oh, yeah, can I come in? Yeah, what's the matter? Ain't he got a number?
Mooney.
Number?
Yeah, skip it. I thought I was somewhere else.
Ready?
Still.
We expected the girl would make trouble, holler for the cops or something, but she fooled us. She came along quiet as a lamb.
Probably didn't want to make trouble for her family's sake. Important Britishers, aren't they?
Must be. When she fell in love with this guy, they run him right out of England. But she ups and follows him.
What was he like?
Good looking, smooth, and as crooked as a snake. Made a business of trimming rich dames. Then her old man got busy on the transatlantic telephone. And before her boat docked in New York, everything was set for her. She hadn't a chance.
Oh, be fair, Hope. As an old friend of the family, I couldn't refuse your father's request.
Yes, but you needn't have been so melodramatic about it.
hiring gunmen.
Private detectives, miss.
No, it's the same thing. You carry guns, don't you? Now, why didn't you come for me yourself, Evie?
I was taking no chances. My job was to get you quietly and safely on board ship and take you home. So I arranged a snitch.
Snatch.
Snatch. That'll be all, my man.
Yes, sir.
You had... Excuse me. I gotta see a fella.
Yeah, we'll wander around the boat and wait for you.
That better hurry.
Better hurry up. The pilot's ready to shove off.
Oh, so you thought you were gonna lose me, huh? Listen, I wanna know what you did with that girl. That girl can push you around the ship for a while.
Investigate this guy. He tried to interfere with us once before. Come on.
Where are they? Stop them. They kidnapped that girl.
Who are you? What's your name?
Well, my name is Hill.
Got your passport with you?
I know.
Where is it?
It's in my cabin.
Go and get it and bring it up to the purser's office. The captain will want to talk to you. Come on.
Give me a light, will you, Evie?
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Oh, Evie, be careful. Oh, just stand there on the ledge. I'll get it.
I said, do be careful, darling. You know you'll go overboard.
Well, now, look, hold on to my ankles. I won't. Now,
yes,
hold
I will. I'll give you a hoist.
All right. Well,
what are you doing, counting the stars? It's, oh, pretty girl, huh?
That fella tried to murder her.
Yeah, he did?
I'm going up there and see what's the matter.
Yeah, wait a minute. Maybe he packs a gat.
Huh?
Yeah, before you talk to him, you want to fan him.
What's that?
Oh, like this. Slap his hip pockets to make sure he doesn't carry a gun.
Yeah?
And this is to make sure he doesn't carry a shoulder holster.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Yeah, if you need any help, call me.
Lovely night, isn't it? You like that suit as well as the stuff they're wearing this year?
I beg your pardon?
Well, no offense, Matt, but could you give me the name of your tailor?
My tailor's in London.
Oh, is he happy there?
You will excuse us now, won't you? I say, I hope we have a calm voyage. The slightest movement makes me seasick. Swell, isn't it? I simply loathe being bounced about.
Happens to be one of the roughest places on the coast.
My dear, it's getting worse.
Oh, this is nothing to what it'll be in a few minutes. I wonder if the good old dining room is open.
Oh, I could use a light snack, maybe a little liver and ice cream with chocolate sauce, or...
Oh, my dear Philip, please.
Maybe
don't.
A good old Yarmouth bloater,
oh,
stuffed with taffy. Some watermelon and peanut butter. I think that'd be nice.
Oh, no, I ask you, no.
There's a big one.
Oh! I say, if you'll excuse me, I think I'll go down and prepare for death.
Now, was that fair?
Fair? Say, I didn't shoot him. I didn't push him overboard or anything. I think it was more than fair. Listen, I want to help you.
Help me? Well, I don't need any help.
Oh, you're very brave, but you're not fooling me because I know you're in danger. I just want to be your friend.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
All right. Don't tell me anything, but I just want you to know from now on you're safe. No matter what they try to do, I'm going to be here to protect you. Because nothing's going to separate us. Nothing. I don't care if there's a whole army. I'll see you a little later.
I'll find him if it takes all night to do it.
Storm best to be over. When I got down, the ship was as steady as... There's that eccentric fellow again. Has he been talking to you?
Why, yes, he has.
Now, my dear, you don't know who or what he may be. I don't like the look of him myself.
Why, I think he's rather nice looking.
The purser is still waiting for you, Mr. Hill.
My, he certainly keeps late hours, doesn't he?
In an emergency, yes. You have your passport, Mr. Hill?
Why, yes.
Well, then let's not keep him waiting any longer.
No.
Look out for the moon.
Sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart. One night of moonlight
can start a typhoon.
Sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart. Control that emotion, whatever you do.
Somebody lies over the ocean and lies in wait for you.
Love can't be found
with a compass or chart, so be smart.
Sailor, beware, be careful, and watch your heart.
See the world across that old Pacific where the gals are all terrific if you like some Oriental. See the world across that old Atlantic where the gals are so romantic if you like some continental.
Go east, young man, go west, young man, but don't go sentimental.
Oh, steer by the North Star, look out for the moon. Oh, sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart. You know that one night of moonlight can start a typhoon. Oh, sailor, beware, beware of your heart.
Control that emotion, whatever you do.
Somebody lies over the ocean, and she lies right there in wait for you.
Love can't be found
with a compass or chart, so be smart, you got to be careful. So beware and watch your heart.
Steer by the North Star, look out for the moon.
Sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart.
One night of moonlight can start a typhoon.
Sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart.
Control that emotion, whatever you do. Somebody lies over the ocean, yes, she lies in wait for you.
Love can't be found with a compass or chart, so be smart.
Sailor, beware, be careful, and watch your heart.
Steer by the North Star,
look out for the moon. You got to look out, sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart.
Oh, beware of your heart.
You know that one night of moonlight can start a typhoon. You got to look out, sailor, beware, beware, beware of your heart.
Oh, beware of your heart.
Control that emotion, whatever you do. Somebody lies over the ocean, and she lies in wait for you.
Love can't be found with a compass or chart, so be smart. Sailor, beware, be careful, and watch your...
It's open. Ah, food, huh?
Where shall I put it, Governor?
Yeah, where do you usually put it?
Well, most of them have breakfast in bed, Governor.
Oh, yeah? Well, I guess that's all right, too.
You don't have to undress, Governor.
Oh, no?
No.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I nearly fell out of this thing last night when we was going around a curve.
Everything all right, Governor?
Yeah, I guess so. How do I look?
Boy, what a night this has been. What a dawn. What a sunrise. What are you doing up there?
This is where you eat breakfast on the boat. What are you doing, going to bed?
No, Doctor, I'm never going to bed on this trip. Listen, you got to help me out.
Say, I got everything all fixed for you.
All right?
Here, take this load of crockery, will you?
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Wait till you see this. Kiko, get a look at that.
Well, Doc, if I had some clothes and a pair of shoes, I'd be all set.
Shoes? Oh, that's easy.
Yeah?
You know, a lot of people have been throwing away their shoes.
Throwing away their shoes?
Yeah. The alley out there is full of them. I'll get you a pair in a minute.
Hey, wait. That duck's all right.
Here you are. Here's a pair. Try these.
Won't do, Doc. They're too small.
Oh, yeah? Well, then I'll get you some others. Start! What's the matter with you?
Oh, don't mind me, Doc.
Well, here you are. You ought to get a pair out of here somewhere.
Oh, that's swell.
Now, the next thing I got to do is to think how I'm going to get you some clothes.
Yes, and another thing, we got to change our cabin.
Why? I think this is kind of cozy. Yeah, I like that top shelf over there.
Well, for one thing, there's a guy on this boat I don't want to run into.
Yeah, who's that?
And he's in that opposite cabin.
Yeah, who's that?
My boss.
No, you don't say. Is he a sourpuss guy with gray hair and wears nose glasses?
That's him. And he mustn't see me on his boat.
Oh, well, look. Maybe if I swipe his glasses, he couldn't see you.
Doctor, I don't know what church you belong to, but brother, you was a Christian.
Yeah, we men of the cloth have our frivolous moments.
Stuart!
Yeah, take it easy.
Go get the glasses.
Yeah, right.
Stuart!
Was she calling for Stuart?
I thought I made that clear to everyone on this boat.
Yeah, I sent him down to the corner. He'd be back in a minute.
Oh, this is a nice little place you got here.
If I don't get up on deck in a minute, it won't do me a bit of good.
The motion of this boat's beginning to get me.
Oh, seasick, huh? Well, maybe you ought to take off your glasses.
I ought to do nothing of the kind. I ought to get up and get some air.
Oh, you want some air? Well, I'll give you some air. Oh, ain't they cute?
Parson, I'm in no mood for anything cute. I may need you later, but now I'd rather suffer alone.
Well, that's all right. Of course, if there's anything you want, why, you just let me know. I'm always glad to...
What's in this room, a flying fish?
I don't know. Maybe it's a seagull. I do all-around minister work, you know, if anything comes up, like a christening or a wedding or maybe a funeral.
Will you get out of here?
Yeah, look, well, I got his glasses.
Nice going.
Did you ring, Governor?
Certainly I rang. I left some shoes in the corridor and they weren't returned.
I'll look them up, Governor.
I want to go up on deck and I can't find my glasses.
I'll take you to your deck chair, and when I find your glasses, I'll bring them up to you.
Well, Doctor? You'll excuse me for a jiff. I'll get me some clothes. I hope he brought his gray suit.
Mort, that was the easiest thing that ever happened to me.
Hello, Mooney.
Hello, Barney. Come in.
Sorry to disturb you, Doctor, but does James Hill occupy this cabin?
Not very much. Why, is there something wrong with his tick?
Well, I think I'd better warn you, Doctor. We've had a radiogram from Washington. He's Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one.
No.
Yes. If he comes back, please detain him and send the little lady up to let me know that he's here.
What a break. They'll grab this guy for Snake Eyes and he'll take the rap.
Yeah, but we mustn't let him, Bonnie.
Why not?
Well, I don't know. I kind of like that fella. Besides, I think he's got a racket. He stayed out all night.
Oh, Moody, don't be a softie.
Well,
I am.
Oh. Yeah, and I'm glad you are. Look.
All set for the trip.
Yeah, you remember Bonnie.
Hello, Bonnie.
Hello.
Yeah, listen, mister, I'm afraid we're in sort of a jam.
Doctor, I shall have to tell your bishop.
Oh, no, nothing like that.
Wise him up, Mooney. Tell him who you are.
Huh? Well, look, I'm not a clergyman. I'm Moonface Martin. I'm a crook. I'm wanted in America.
What do they want with another crook in America?
You don't realize who he is. Moonface is public enemy number 13.
Yeah, please, Bonnie, we don't have to mention numbers.
Now, Mooney, you're going to work up. You got me to help you. When the new list comes out, you might be 6 or 7.
Yeah, Washington didn't treat me very fair in that last list. Putting Rat-Nose Dugan ahead of me. Anyway, I don't see why they don't skip 13 like they do in office buildings.
Like he must have clipped this off a poor tear.
Yeah, will you listen to me, please?
Doctor, some other time, not now.
Make him listen, Mooney. Make him listen.
Now, you listen to me or I'll blow the top of your head off.
Hey, what do you got there?
That's me old pal. Put.
Put it away, will you? Stop playing with that thing. I'm your pal. I'm not going to give you away, but I got to get up on that deck.
Yeah, that's just what I'm leading up to. That ticket I gave you belonged to public enemy number one.
Public enemy number one? You mean that punchy-looking fellow on the passport picture?
Say, don't you go running down Snake Eyes Johnson.
Snake Eyes Johnson?
Yeah, Snake Eyes Johnson.
So you see, we got to hide you someplace.
But I can't hide. I got to find that girl. Gee, she might be in danger right now.
Yeah, but the purser is looking for you. Of course, I could kill the purser.
Yes. No, you can't do that. Well, what could they do to me?
Well, there has been rumors that they're going to electrocute Snake Eyes.
They'll go all through the passengers till they find you.
Oh, well, that'd be a cinch.
Wait a minute, Mooney. Not so fast. You stay here. I've got an idea.
We're one day out and the time drags on and we wish we could go and die.
All the girls we left behind us, we know, are engaged to some other guy.
We know that womankind is false. They lie with every glance.
But after we get into port, we're going to give them one more chance.
There will always be a lady fair. A Jenny Fair or a Sadie Fair, there'll always be a Lady Fair who's waiting there for you.
There will always be a Lady Fair to smooth your troubles and to mush your hair.
There'll always be a Lady Fair who's waiting there for you.
I am looking somewhat tanner. Don't blame it on the sun. It's the moonlight and the sweetness in your manner that's making me the healthy one. When the moon hangs low, I begin to glow, and my day has just begun. I'm gonna get a moonbath when I'm with you tonight. tonight. So very soon I'll moon burn when you hold me tight. I'll ask the glowing stars up above me what your lips will impart. And when they flash the word that you love me, it'll warm my heart. I'll get a brand new moonbird with every kiss from you. And if I have my way, if I can have my say, you'll get a moonbird too. I'm catching me some moonbird when I get you alone with me tonight. So very soon I'll moonbird when you hold me tight. I'll ask the glowing stars up above me, tell me what your lips will impart. And when they flash the word that you love me, ooh, it'll warm my heart. I'm gonna get me a brand new kind of a moonburn with every kiss I get from you. And if I have my way, get my say, you'll get a moonburn too. Stay undercover, you'll get a moonburn too.
See, it is.
Is everything all right?
Perfectly. But may I ask, are you crazy?
Yes, a little. About you. Why?
Well, you pop up in such unexpected places.
Yes, don't I?
And in such strange attire.
Oh, I think it fits me rather well. A bit snug in spots, maybe.
But if you're doing it for me, you needn't.
Is that nice?
You seem to think I'm in danger of some sort.
Well, you don't have to tell me unless you feel
it. No, but really, I'm perfectly all right.
Oh, now, looky here. Just for saying hello to you to nightclub, I get stuck up with a gun. I ask about you on a boat, and I get slugged silly. You can't expect me to believe
that
everything...
It's perfectly simple. I ran away from home.
You ran away?
Yes, and Lord Oakley, a friend of the family, is bringing me back.
Oh, you mean the long guy with the snars?
Snars?
Nose.
Incredible as it may seem, that's the whole story.
Honest?
Honor bright.
Well, even if I made a first-class sap out of myself, I'm glad to hear it. Very glad.
Look, suppose you drop that disguise and get into some clothes, and then we'll do something.
I can't.
Well, why not?
Well, among other things, the boss is on board.
Well, would he mind?
Would he mind? Listen, I'm supposed to be back in New York holding up Wall Street for him. Instead of that, I let everything drop and follow you.
Oh, I am sorry. You have made rather a mess of things, haven't you?
Yes, but it's been worth it. Meeting you.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh, there you are. Jolly bracing this morning, isn't it? I've been on the sun deck since 9 o'clock.
Oh, this silly woman up there, watching the seagulls fly around. Can you tell, she said, where the seagulls go at night? Seagulls, I said? Go to the gallery at night. Do you know, my dear, she went off like a flash of lightning in search of the gallery. Very amusing, don't you think? Oh, very amusing.
What?
Good morning, Miss Harcourt.
Good morning, Captain.
Lord Oakley.
Morning. Bit of a gale blowing, isn't there?
Nothing to speak of, sir. I hope it isn't making you uncomfortable.
We Oakleys are such bad sailors. I hope you have pleasant weather ahead.
Yes, indeed, sir. I look forward to a very smooth crossing.
Yes, let's hope you're right.
Anything I can do to make you comfortable, let me know.
What are you doing with the bucket? Rushing the growler?
Oh, I'm betting the ship.
Yeah, well, it looks all right to me.
Well, it won't when I get through with it.
Oh, that outfit is great. Nobody would ever know you.
Little thing I...
Well, if you aren't the funniest looking sailor I ever saw.
Yes, you're right. It's in perfect disguise.
What are you doing, working your way across?
Well, you wouldn't help me, so my good friend the doc here offered to pitch
in. The doc? Say, wait a minute. Come out from behind that collar. I know you, Moonface.
Well, that makes both our disguises perfect.
Oh, why, that's Moonface Martin, the slickest con man in the world.
Yeah, no more. I ain't a con man no more. I got out of it when the mortgage companies took it over.
Say, Billy, how are you getting along with your new girlfriend?
Oh, not so hot. There's an Englishman hangs around all the time and watches her.
Can I help you?
You mean you would?
Can't stay mad at you. And to prove it, I'll take that English accent off your hands.
I think we better bump him off.
Huh? No, Doc. No rough stuff. Why, yes, madam. You go down three decks, turn to your right, and ask for Curly Top.
Have you seen him yet, Doctor?
Who's that?
Why, Snake Eyes Johnson.
Personally, I think he got off the boat.
Why, that's impossible. Do you realize how far he'd have to swim?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. But aren't you overlooking the possibility of water wings?
Huh? Water wings. He may have slipped down into the second or third class. I'll have a look for him there.
Yeah, he may have slipped down there.
Say, what is this Englishman to Billy's girl?
I think they're engaged.
Well, do you know him?
Well, I know him when I hear him. He's got a monocle in his throat. I wonder if that guy's suitable for framing.
Just how do you mean?
Couldn't you date him up and get him running a temperature?
Oh, those Englishmen have awfully high boiling points.
You see, if you could wear something that kind of falls off easy, I could bust in and accuse him of tearing your clothes off, see?
Oh, I get it. So that when his girlfriend shows up, she'll give him the air, huh?
Yeah, that was the idea.
You know, if you weren't a friend of Billy's, I'd unfrock you.
Please, Reno, there's a time and place for everything. Let's go find him. Give me a glass of milk, could you? What'll you have, daughter?
Well, I'll have the same, please.
Hello, Padre.
No, I guess you're mistaken. Moon is my moniker.
Monica?
That's my name.
Oh, Monica, yes, Monica. Mm. Are you taking your sabbatical abroad?
No, she's not my sabbatical. No, she's Reno Sweeney.
Oh, the chanteuse.
Well, she never went as far as that. Reno, Miss Sweeney, I want you to meet this guy. His kink.
How do you do? Evelyn Oakley is my moniker.
Oh, really?
I'm delighted to meet you, Miss Sweeney. I spent an evening at your nightclub once. It's quite eventful. You affected me so much that I turned to the frail I was with and said, look here, why don't we get married in a year or two?
Yeah, you certainly work fast, don't you?
Yes.
It's milk.
Yes. I say, can't we get together for cocktails in my cabin before lunch?
Oh, this is too easy.
I beg your pardon?
Yeah, I say it's too easy to succumb to temptation. I never touch intoxicating liquors myself. It's much.
Well, I'll be glad to come.
Right, then I'll see you at one. Come in.
Did you ring, sir?
Oh, there you are. Bring me a dozen martini cocktails, will you? And steward, make it snappy. Yes. Make it snappy.
Yes, sir.
Come in. Just put it on the bed, will you? Leave there.
beg your pardon.
Hello.
I say, I thought it was the steward with my cocktails. I'm awfully glad it's you. We've got oodles of time before lunch. Do sit down, will you? I do so want to have a chat with you.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way about me, because I'm certainly that way about you.
What way?
Oh, that way.
Oh, you know I love your American expressions. I'm making a collection of them. Just a minute, will you? To feel that way about a person means to rub his neck. I say, do tell me some others, will you?
Well, you don't understand. I mean, you do things to me.
I do things to you?
Evie, that means I like you.
Oh, it means you like me. How devastating. Racy language, the American verse. You do things to me.
Oh, I give up.
You do things to me.
What's going on here? So this is what I find. You beast. You despoiler of innocent girlhood. Look at this poor child, her clothes torn off by your fiendish attack, standing there in all her nakedness. Must be something wrong here.
No, there's nothing wrong here.
Well, maybe I'm wrong. Wait a minute. What's going on here? You beast, sitting there in your nakedness, your clothes torn off in a fiendish attack by this innocent girl.
Hey, wait a minute, Moonface.
No, stand back. I will not permit this British lion to twist... I will not permit American womanhood to twist the British lion by the tail. And don't think Miss Harcourt won't know about this, because I'm going to tell her.
Yes, do tell her, and make it thicker, will you? She's always complaining I lack fervor.
No, wait a minute. You don't get the idea.
And be sure and call me a beast. I rather like that one. You don't mind, Miss Sweetie, do you?
Well, now, wait a minute.
Yeah, wait a minute. You ain't taking the right attitude. You're supposed to get scared. Well, go on, get scared. Yeah, this is a serious business. I'm a dangerous man.
Oh, come, Padre. You're an old dear, and you know it.
Yeah, I'll prove to you I'm a desperate character. Do you mind waiting a minute? Don't go away.
I say, do you know what's wrong with the little fellow?
Listen, Evie, I really like you, and I'll give you the lowdown, even if I have to take the rap myself. He was set to bust in here and catch us in a clinch, and you didn't clinch, that's all.
You mean he thought I'd make love to you?
Well, that was my idea when I came in here.
How exciting.
Now, I guess you realize how serious this is.
Hey, what are you trying to pull? Give me that gun.
No.
Give me that...
It's all right, Padre. You thought I'd take advantage of Miss Sweeney, and you came to her rescue. And I admire you for it. I can't tell you how much I admire you, Padre. You do things to me.
Keep away from me or I'll shoot.
Miss Harcourt?
Yes. Thank you.
Wish anything, miss?
No, I didn't ring.
A sailor told me your bell was out of order and you called for a steward.
Well, there must be some mistake.
Sorry, miss. The bathroom tap reported out of order, miss.
All right, come in.
Discussing your charm, we decided that you should be in my arms. My arms and I felt a thrill at the start. We decided that you should be in my heart. We're so in love with you, both my heart.
love me too. And as years go by, both my heart and I will forever be true. For all that I want is your heart.
My heart and I,
my heart and I, we're discussing your charm. We decided that you should be in my arms, my arms. And I felt a thrill at the start. We decided that you should be in my heart. We're so in love with you, both my heart and I. Love me too. Then as years go by, both my heart and I will forever be. For all that I want is your heart and you.
Mine's laudanum.
Well, that's interesting. No, we don't want any, thank you. No.
No, no soup. No soup.
I said we don't want it.
Yeah, we do.
Billy.
Shh. Oh, that's no good. That outfit won't do.
You're telling me. Listen, Doc, you've got to go down to the cabin and get me a suit of clothes.
I can't. This guard's hanging all over the doorknob.
Well, I've got to get a suit of clothes somewhere.
Hey, there's a suit of clothes. Only there's a man in it.
Yeah, I'll investigate. He's asleep. He's got a suit on.
Then he don't need the suit. Let's take it off.
You watch the stairs, Reno.
Yeah, that's a man's job. Hey, here comes someone.
Good. Hey, go on. Play somewhere else. Scat.
My aunt says I can play anywhere on this boat I want.
Yeah, well, you go get your aunt and play with her. Here, tell her to chew on this. Come on now, let's get busy,
let's go,
see?
Huh?
Let's get busy.
Hey, Sonny. Wait just a minute. You like to do that?
Sure. I like to stick them and see them jump.
You do, huh? Would you like to do it again?
Yeah, no
not
more.
You.
No,
wait,
I can't
on.
Take
I'll
it.
Come here.
Really, Mr. Whitney, you can't go around like this.
What?
I beg your pardon.
Well, how do you like that? All the people on this boat, and we got to steal my boss's pants.
We should have gotten his coat, too.
Oh, yeah, but even if he had a coat, he'd still need a beard.
What goes on here?
Yeah, we're looking for a beard.
Yeah.
There's a beard.
Down to the barber shop and borrow a pair of clippers.
Doc, I admire the way your mind works, but you can't get away with that.
Billy, the kid's got a cute thought. Let's dwell on it. Here's your hat and coat.
It's okay, boys.
Yeah,
it's all right.
It's stupid. Wait a minute.
Friends.
Hey. Whaley lights.
Oh.
Hey, Doc, pick a fight with him. You know.
Oh, hello.
You can't say that to me and get away with it. You take off your coat. We'll fight it out right here.
What's the matter with
you? Why, go ahead. Knock his block off. I wouldn't take that from anybody. I'll hold your coat.
You want to fight?
Yeah.
All right. I apologize.
Yeah, I guess it won't work now.
Hey, who said I won't work? My wife told you to say that. It's a lie. You can't say that to me.
I get a kick out of this world.
Well, here's a pair of pants.
Right.
And a tie.
Yes, ma'am. Coat and a hat. Well, I guess this fixes me up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but you still... Look, you still gotta have something to cover that face.
Yeah.
Gee whiz. If I only had a beard.
Yeah, if you only had a beard.
If he only had a beard.
That's all the man had.
Well, and very nice, too.
Hey, look, listen.
We'll get a clip out of you.
Oh, how do you do, sister?
How do you do?
Could we have a little conversation together?
Yes, indeed, Doctor.
Yeah, would you sit down?
Thank you. You know, I've seen you abroad, and I've been so eager to make your acquaintance.
Is that so? Well...
Yes, indeed. We've a lot to talk about.
You don't say. Well.
You see, I'm honorary president of the Texas Uplift League.
Yeah, well, I prefer the Nationals myself. You don't say.
Yes, I'm an ardent fighter for reform in the school.
Oh, well, then I'm your man. We forget only too quickly what we learned at reform schools.
Why, Doctor, are you interested in prison reform?
Oh, yes, indeed. Oh, yes, indeed.
Surely you don't approve of capital punishment.
What was good enough for my father is good enough for me. I'll never forget what a judge once said to me. He said, we skipped that sentence. What do you think of the Detroit Tigers?
The Detroit Tigers? I knew a family in Detroit by the name of Lions.
Lions? Well, I knew Max Bear, but he was from San Francisco.
I don't think I understood just what you said.
Well, that's all right. I wasn't listening.
Doctor, I've enjoyed this little chat very much.
Yeah, I'm glad somebody has.
I hope I'll see you again sometime.
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
I'm sure I will.
Goodbye. Good.
Now that's what I call putting on the dog.
Well, tell the truth, I feel like a dog.
Well, what do you mean?
Reno, you're really a pal. You ask me to sail with you, and I say no. And I fall for another girl, and you still help me.
Well, I guess you know why. At words poetic, I'm so pathetic that I always have found it best, instead of getting them off my chest,
what then?
To let them rest unexpressed. I hate parading my serenading, for I'd probably miss a bar. But if this ditty is not so pretty, at least it'll tell you how great you are.
Proceed.
You're the top.
You're just saying that.
You're the Swanee River.
Whoa.
You're the top. You're a V8 flipper. You're the buds that grow when the winter snow drift thaws.
Oh,
you're the walls of China. You're Carolina.
Yeah,
you're Santa Claus.
make more.
You're a knight in the streets of Cairo. You're a flight in an auto gyro. I'm the lazy hound that hangs around the shop. Oh. But a baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
Oh, Reno, you're the top.
Me?
Yes, ma'am. You're the roof of heaven.
Oh.
You're the top.
Now you're kidding.
I wouldn't kid you. You're a lucky seven.
Ah.
You're the curves that whiz from an arm like Dizzy Dean's. Strike your Niagara's waters, your Dion's daughters, and your Boston beans.
The beans come from Boston.
Yes, ma'am. You're the grave. Mr. Einstein's noodle. And your weight, well, let's see. An apple strudel.
Thanks loads.
I'm a good for naught,
no.
An afterthought, a flaw. But a baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top. Why, you're the top. You is a king, tut, mama, mama, me.
You're the top. You're Paul White, Mr. Tummy.
Oh, no more, you should see him. You're an angel, you're simply too, too, too divine. Why, you're Botticelli.
You're Keats.
You're Shelley.
You're Listerine. You're a boom. You're the dam at Boulder. You're the moon over Mae West's shoulder.
I'm a worn-out blade that can't be made to strut.
But if I'm beyond assistance, you're the top. You're the top. You're a Bengal lancer.
Right. You're the top. You're the burlesque dancer.
Here, stick this on and get it on real tight. You're a Gershwin ditty.
And you think I'm pretty?
Baby, you're dynamite.
Oh, thanks so much, baby.
In that beard.
Some stylish beard.
You look Romanian.
But I'm afeard.
Come on, come on.
I'm a Pomeranian.
Ouch, it's full of fleas.
I'm afraid to sneeze or cough. Here comes the person.
What could be worse than that? Gets us off.
Come in.
Oh, Dr. Moon. We were just beginning a search for you.
Uh-oh.
I'm afraid we have some bad news for you.
Yeah, well, I was afraid we wouldn't get away with it.
It's about your pupils.
Yeah, why? What's the matter with my pupils?
I mean your Chinese pupils.
Them.
We don't allow gambling in the third class. You must make them understand, or we'll have to lock them up. I've sent for them, and I'm going to turn them over to you.
Yeah, now look here now. I got enough troubles as it is without you ringing in a couple of Chinese on me.
But you must talk to them, Doctor. After all, you're responsible for them. Every time we speak to them, they tell us to see the bishop.
The bishop, huh?
There they are, sir. Come on, get in here.
Hello.
Maybe I said something. Do you mind? I think I'd better talk to these boys alone.
All right, I'll leave them here with you for a while, Doctor. Shut the door.
What can I do for you boys?
Where's the bishop?
Well, the bishop ain't here right now. Is there anything I can do?
The shipman take away cards.
Oh, you've been gambling, huh? Well, don't you know good Christians never gamble? Not only is it sinful, but if you don't know how to deal from the bottom, you lose all your money.
Oh, we not lose. We win. $300.
Yes, $300.
You've got $300. There's a little game I'd like to show you. Get down there on the floor. Now, look, I got $50, see? I put up my 50 and you put up your 300. I throw a number, and if I throw the same number before I throw it 7, I win. If I don't, you win. You understand it? Oh, money from home.
Here it is. Baby.
Get here. Here, wait a minute.
Buck scarf.
Craps, you lose.
Yeah, well, I didn't say anything about that.
Oh, we know about that.
Yeah, I can see you do. Well, we'll try it again. Look, you put your money on the floor, and I'll put mine on the cup, see? And we'll...
and make them better men, although they're pretty good already. I think they'll be all right now.
Thank you, Doctor, for your help.
Oh, that's all right. Just part of the daily routine.
Take them below.
Yes, sir.
Ah, dinner, huh?
No, that's the trap shooting contest on the upper deck.
Yeah, now look here. If there's going to be any more crap shooting on this boat, I won't play unless you buy those Chinese.
Oh, no, Doctor. Trap shooting contest. You know, you shoot at clay pigeons with guns.
What do you shoot for?
Well, the first prize is $50.
Can I use my own gun?
Why, certainly, Doctor. It starts in 15 minutes. You'll excuse me?
Even Stephen.
Pull!
Thank you, Stuart.
Excellent score, sir.
Yes, of course.
Here you are, sir.
Pull! I say 24 out of 25, not bad, what?
Splendid, Ethan. You ought to win.
My heart and I will forever be true. For all that I want is your heart and you. Well, for my goodness alive sakes, is this not Miss Haircut?
Harcourt. Hope Harcourt. This is Sir Evelyn Oakley.
Signor Arturo del Artino del Greco. How do you do? Won't you sit down?
Gracias.
I was told I should introduce myself to you by my dear cousin, the Duke de Fonfonsidi.
The Duke of Fonfonsidi?
Yeah.
Well, I must have met him in Paris.
Ah, the French. They have been so kind to my poor family since the Revolution. Yes, you have to take your hat off to the French. You have to take your shirt off to the French. I say!
Gun, sir?
What's the matter with you?
I say, old boy, are you ill?
This man, Evie, I know.
Nervous or something, I think. I don't know what it is. What's this something?
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the trap shooting contest is the Reverend Dr. Moon.
Excuse me, no? You see, I'm a little shell-shocked when the revolution, she is coming to my beloved country. Is it?
I'm so sorry you aren't feeling well. I'd love to hear that delightful tune you just sang.
To sing for Mademoiselle, I would gladly leave a very sick bed. Is it not?
No, it isn't.
Gracias. My heart and I, very disgusting your charms, we decided that you should be in my arms, and I felt such a thrill at this time, we decided that you should be in my heart, we're so in love with you, both my heart and I, love me, me too. And then as
I
years
say, dogs
go
do by, take to you, don't they?
Both my heart and I will forever be true. For all that I want is your heart and you.
Big fellow, he thinks he's lapdog.
Hello!
How are you, Mr. Johnson? Captain, here's our man.
Who do you think I am?
I know who you are. You're Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one.
Hands up! One false move and I'll shoot.
Disarm that man.
Bonnie, grab the fiddle. Yeah, don't get tough now.
Let me have that gun. Dr. Moon,
What's the meaning of this?
I'm no doctor. Please,
Moonface Martin, public enemy number 13.
Barney, how many times have I asked you not to mention numbers?
And who are you?
I'm Mrs. Snake Eyes Johnson. Come on, Evie, let's go.
Wait a minute. I'm no public enemy. My name is Crocker, William Crocker.
Never talk.
Take them away.
Wait a minute, Captain. You're making a big mistake. Now, I can prove who I am. Here's Mr. Whitney. Mr. Whitney's my boss. He'll tell you who I am.
Do you know that man?
I never saw him before.
They're over there in the royal suite.
Hello, Reno.
Yeah, are you going to spring us?
Well, I've been to the captain. I've told them all who you are, but they won't believe me.
Well, have you seen her?
She's hiding in her cabin. She won't talk to anybody.
Well, you've got to see her and explain. Gee, Reno, you don't know what this means to me.
Well, I've worked on your boss, too, but no luck. He saw her. He says this'll teach you a lesson.
He would.
I've tried to reason with Sir Oakley, but he thinks I'm your gun moll.
Yeah, well, now, don't worry. We'll beat the rap somehow.
We probably will, but by that time she'll be married or something.
Well, you still got me. She may be prettier than I am, but she can't like you anymore. So with Reno and me.
You're the Tom. You're the Swanee River. You're the Tom. You're a goose's liver. By a girly side, you're the envy of every man. You're the Russian ballet, you're Rudy Valet.
You're Caliban.
She must be disgusted with me.
You're much more. You're a field of clover.
I'm the floor. When the ball is over.
Well, don't worry, Billy. You'll see her all right.
Yeah, but when? She's somebody else's wife.
All right, miss, your time is up.
Your landing card, what?
Thanks.
No more Americans, what?
No more Americans.
That's Mrs. Ronald MacPhail, what?
Quite.
That's right. Pick you up in about 10 minutes.
Hey!
Hello.
Not a very warm reception, Evie.
My dear Reno, if you still persist, I say, what are you doing with all those things on your head?
Oh, never mind about that. I've just seen the captain, and it's no use. You're the only one left who can help Billy. He's so much in love with Miss Harcourt.
So you see, even if I didn't believe Billy was a public enemy, it's too late now anyway.
Not if we work fast.
Oh, I know, Sepp. I know who he is. I know who you are, too. You're a gunman's moll, that's what you are. Why, the very first time you met me, you tried to play the badger game on me. You said so yourself.
But that was only to give Billy a chance.
Oh, and who is this Billy? The American government says he's a public enemy and you say he's not. Who am I to believe, you or your uncle?
Uncle?
Samuel or whatever the fellow's name is runs the government, the whole thing. You know the fellow I mean.
Oh, I can't get to Miss Harcourt. The captain won't believe me and you won't believe me. I guess I'd better give up.
Why don't you reform? You know, if you'd only change your ways, I could go for you. You know, dash it all, I'm that way about you.
You mean you're in love with me?
Terrifically.
Well, I get a kick out of you, too.
It's no use. I can't be expected to marry a gunman's moll. Why, the honor of the family comes into it. We all have our honor, haven't we?
You certainly can ask the most embarrassing questions.
48, 49, 50, 51. Oh. Merry old England.
Imagine 5 days in this joint. It's a wonder I haven't gone nuts.
Oh, well, this ain't so bad. Was you ever in jail in Cicero? Yeah, I don't mean the new one, I mean the old one.
Listen, Doc, will you lay off those travel lectures? I'm sick of them.
You know, I've been in a lot of tough hoosegars in my life, but in Split Lip, Nevada, they got the cutest little jail you ever saw.
You want to do me a favor, Doc? Just keep quiet.
Well, all right. I was only trying to keep your mind on something cheerful. Yeah, I knew you were thinking about her.
I know, Doc. You've really been pretty swell.
Yeah, well, will you stop worrying? Do me a favor and you'll hear from her.
Well, she's landing today. I'll never see her again.
Well, sure you will. Sure you will. They can't give you no more than 10 years.
10 years? Boy, you're sure a big help.
Well, you're better off than I am at that.
You!
Now, Doc, don't start crying for me.
You!
Yeah, hey, look, look.
Why, the boat's turned over.
Yeah, I know that face. Yeah, it's Reno.
Listen, I gotta work fast. I got a sail holding me by the feet. They won't let me down to see you.
Yeah, well, what's gonna happen to us?
Well, they ain't gonna let you off. They're gonna send you right back. Is there anything I can do for you?
Well, you might...
Wait a minute, Doc. Listen, Reno, have you seen Miss Harcourt?
No, but I've seen Sir Oakley. They're marrying Miss Harcourt off to Captain MacPhail just as soon as she lands.
Oh, listen, Reno, you must see her.
But, Billy, it's no use. I've tried everything. Well, I guess I'll have to say goodbye.
Can you get us some cigarettes before you go?
Sure, just a minute. Hey there, gone up?
Gee whiz, if she could only get to her for a minute and talk to her.
Hey, our kids.
Yeah, thanks. Hey, what's the idea of the Chinese get-up?
Well, we're doing a big Chinese number on the dock.
On the dock?
Yeah, Sam's idea. The most colossal publicity stunt ever pulled off on this side of the Atlantic. Hey, listen, you mugs, hey, cut that out!
I'm gonna get out of here if I have to tear this ship apart. Now, what am
I... Open it up. Go on, get in there. Lock it up.
What are you boys in for?
We clean whole third class out in crap game.
Oh, is that so?
Shipman take away money, but he say we get out when ship land.
Oh, lucky boys.
Well, mine fits. How's yours?
Yeah, well, the coat's all right, but I don't know so much about the skirt. You boys play poker?
We don't got any money.
Oh, you don't need money, no. This is strip poker.
Step in the office here.
You don't bet money. You bet something you weren't, see? You boys play stud?
Oh, we hip-sobby stud.
Hip-sobby stud.
Yeah, stud. I thought you would. Well, here we go. All right, you're high, Billy. What do you bet?
Well, I'll bet my coat.
Yeah, you stay for a coat?
I stay for a coat.
I stay for a coat.
I stay for a coat. Now, you're high. What do you bet?
I bet my pants.
Yeah, you call pants?
I call pants.
You call pants?
I call pants.
Yeah, I call pants. Calling all pants, calling all pants, calling all pants.
China boy, you catch inside the Missy Hope?
No catchy. They got a special place for British subjects. She must go through there.
Okay, I guess we scram.
Yeah. We scram.
Up to speed.
Reno Sweeney and her widows present their celebrated Chinese number on the Southampton docks.
Oh.
I've never been so humiliated in my entire career in the theater.
Yes, well, it's bad all over the country.
Much money, Chinese big shots, boy, foo foo. Me, good time, Chinese Charlie, and I'd like to have a chat with you.
You gotta have rhythm if you want romance. You gotta have rhythm, or you haven't got a Chinaman's chance.
Oh. Me like American rhythm, I'd like to sing a song for you. Me like hardcore tissue, arena goes for Oakley too. You're the top, you're the top, you're the top. All the same and like a lotus.
You're the top, you're the top, you're the top. You're a mustard poultice.
Stars over Shanghai. Moon hanging low. But nobody wanna make chop suey. Everybody wants to do it.
Shanghai.
Mr. Gangster.
Will you stop calling me a gangster?
Gangster, gangster, that's all you are, a married gangster.
I'm not married. I'm a single gangster. I mean...
Oh, so you admit it. And you are married.
Darling, please listen
to
me.
Will you let me out of here?
Come on now. I hope you've got to believe me. I love you.
Yeah, hey, Barney. Who let you out?
The captain. Everything's okay.
Yeah?
Read this. Real Snake Eyes Johnson... arrested in New York last night. Release man you are holding with full apologies.
I say that's splendid. There's nothing to stop us now.
What does it say about me?
Moonface Martin, once rated public enemy number 13, is now relegated to 1313.
1313?
Not dangerous and not wanted.
I can't understand this administration.